Gray Coleman, 28, shot. Christopher McCann, 45, shot. Alexandra Hall, 25, shot.
These are not just names. They're loved ones taken too soon from gun violence across New Orleans.
Those are people. Those are our children. Those were the future that has been snatched out of our hands in this community.
Because of the increase in crime in the city, some of the people you see all the time.
Looks cost, bro, if you're gonna use it.
Those who make sure your hair is in tip-top shape are stepping up to show they care beyond the chair.
You don't have to pick up a gun. There's other options, and life is way more valuable than just, you know, killing each other. We gotta hold ourselves to a higher standard than just killing each other.
It's excessive. It's ridiculous. We're trying to figure out as a whole what to do about it.
Dorian Bayham and Christopher Womack are two of the 10 people who participated in New Orleans' very first barber and beautician program.
Thank you, Patrick.
It's led by Cure Violence New Orleans.
We're identifying individuals in the community that are potentially get shot or shoot somebody based on their risk. We have to be able to come about a strategic plan to intervene in on their life.
Hakeem Kashif is the supervisor of training,
which is very critical.
And he started working with this group back in March. Week after week, they learned how to identify conflict, intervene before anything happens, and change the social norms. Womack said it's important for them to do this, to use their influence, so they can make a difference across New Orleans.
Our instructors call them, you know, antibodies. Like, we are the antibodies. We the ones in the community as molds to try to help redirect the minds of the youth and other people in the community.
What we are doing, according to research, we found that if we touch every aspect, every nick and cranny of our city with this type of training, we will reduce shootings and killings overnight. It's that easy.
Emmanuel Benjamin, 19, shot.
In New Orleans, Christina Watkins, WDSU News.